Good, perfect. You can maybe they'll put it underneath my chair, right there. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
I should welcome you all on this wonderful day in which we're going to be making our consecration to Mary by celebrating the votive mass of the Immaculate Heart of Mary. So as we prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who prepared a fit dwelling place for the Holy Spirit in the heart of the Blessed Virgin Mary, graciously grant that through our intercession we may be a worthy temple of your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
And merciful.
my soul, and forgive not all his benefits.
Merciful.
He pardons all your iniquities. He heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction. He crowns you with kindness and compassion.
Lord is kind and merciful.
Merciful and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. He will not always chide, nor does his wrath forever. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so surpassing is his kindness towards those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he put our transgressions from us.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Read the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus came into the district of Judea and across the Jordan. Again, crowds gathered around him, and as was his custom, he again taught them. Pharisees approached him and asked, "Is it lawful for a husband to divorce his wife?" They were testing him. He said to them in reply, "What did Moses command you?" They replied, "Moses permitted a husband to write a bill of divorce and dismiss her." Jesus told them, "Because of the hardness of your hearts, he wrote you this commandment. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife. The two shall become one flesh, so they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate." In the house, the disciples again questioned Jesus about this. He said to them, "Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her. And if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery." The Gospel of the Lord. So this is the method that we're going to be following in our consecration to Mary. After my homily, we will be praying our act of consecration to Mary. And hopefully all of you have that act of consecration with you. You have a card, or you have in my book, it'll be the consecration written by St. Louis de Montfort. Then after that, we will bless your scapulars, and then we'll be imposing the scapulars on. Then we'll proceed in the Mass. And at the end of the Mass, we will expose the Blessed Sacrament and we'll pray the Rosary and then the chaplet. And then after that, we will have a a Eucharistic Marian procession, which will have the Blessed Sacrament exposed, and we'll go around the church 2.5 times, and we will receive the blessing with the Eucharistic Lord. So that's the way we'll be doing it, so you won't be taken by surprise, okay? Okay, my homily is going to be based on an article that came out in the Ligurian magazine probably more than 50 years ago. So I'd like to give you a summary of the article, and then I'd like to extrapolate from that. Really, what is Mary doing in her lives? What are the presence of Mary? Okay, it starts with this. You who are my age or even older probably knows that after the Second Vatican Council, the United States, the Catholic Church in this country, was very much influenced by the iconoclastic heresy. Now that's a really big terminology. I try to put it in layman's English. The iconoclastic heresy means, after Vatican II, in many liberal places, they try to get rid of the statues, the stained glass windows, the sacramentals, such that many places in the United States, it almost looked like a Quaker church. No? And especially for Filipinos and Mexicans, you probably never experienced that. Okay, but in where I was brought up and raised, that was part and parcel of the heresy that was permeating. Thanks be to God for the Filipino culture and the Mexican culture. You can't take statues and stained glass. It's like pulling the plug out. But that theological error had permeated many liberal places in the United States. So that's the theological backdrop of this story. So a priest arrives at a parish. He's a new pastor, and the pastor before him was poisoned by the iconoclastic heresy, such that almost all the statues were taken out of the church, and it looked like almost like a whitewashed Quaker building. You know? So this priest believed that we should have statues in the church. Statues, paintings, stained glass windows. So he went outside, and in the garage, there was a statue of the Blessed Mother. So the Blessed Mother was not in the church, but in the garage. It had been there for several years, and it was filled with cobwebs, and the paint was chipping. It's a beautiful statue, but if you leave a statue in a damp garage for 3 or 4 years, guess what's going to happen? So he wanted to restore that statue to the church in one of the niches, which was empty. So he brought it to a paint shop. So he brought it to the paint shop and asked the painters to repaint the statue. And the painters there were not, like you people, not practicing Catholics, going to Mass every day, confession twice a week. These people were, these men were basically very worldly, to put it mildly. And their obligation was to paint the statue of the Blessed Mother. They had never had anything like this to do in their paint shop. So they started to paint, and almost immediately they no longer told bad jokes. They no longer used bad words. Because how could they do it in front of the statue of Mary? So they kept painting. It took a couple of days. And the following day, one of them was an ex-Catholic, said, "Well, why don't we say Hail Mary?" And the following day, someone was speaking about how he used to go to church, was an altar boy, no? And it was such that the whole environment was radically transformed. And the owner of the shop called the priest and said, get this statue out of my shop. It's being turned into a chapel. So, after they finished, the priest paid the owner of the shop his due, and then the statue was placed in a prominent niche in the church, which had been vacant for several years because of the iconoclastic heresy. Okay, so you've heard the first part of the story. Let's move into the second part of the story. Second part of the story was the following. There was a young woman that had a great devotion to Mary and asked the priest if she could embellish the statue of Mary by adorning it with a bouquet of roses every day. And the priest said, fine, by all means. So every morning she'd come in and place the bouquet of roses in front of this statue of the Blessed Mother. And now the statue was very beautiful. I mean, these men, even though they were not daily communicants, they were professional painters, and they really did a good job. And the priest paid a pretty penny to have that done. So this woman, every morning would come in and place this beautiful bouquet of roses in front of the statue. But something happened. She fell in love. She fell in love. But she fell in love with a non-believer. And the non-believer convinced her to take off to Las Vegas and to have a nice civil wedding there in Las Vegas. Not to get married in the church, but in Las Vegas. So, she decided that before going to Las Vegas, that she would talk with the priest. So she goes to the rectory, knocks on the door, she asks for an appointment with the priest, and he tells her, okay, why don't you meet me tomorrow at 3 o'clock? So they go into the parlor. She says, Father, you know, I've always had a great love for this church, and I've been embellishing, decorating the image of Mary for a long time now. But it looks like I'm marrying this man, and we're getting married in Las Vegas. So the priest listened very attentively. He didn't say anything. So he pulled out a pad of paper, and he started to write and write and write and write for about 3 or 4 minutes. Then he closed the pad of paper, gave the note to her, and said, will you do me a favor? Of course, Father. I want you now to go into the church, kneel down in front of the Blessed Mother, and I want you to open up this note, this message. Can you do that for me? Of course, Father. So she goes into the church, and there is the beautiful image of Mary and the flowers that she put there in the morning, these beautiful roses. She opens up the pad of paper. And this is what was written. Dear Mother Mary, I have loved you for many, many years. But it looks as if I've chosen a different path. I decided to get married in Las Vegas with my future husband. Goodbye, and I will never see you again. Goodbye. Two hours later, the priest came into the church to close the church. There she was. She was weeping for 2 hours. in front of the Blessed Virgin Mary. To make a long story short, she dumped the guy, okay? And eventually she fell in love with a good Catholic and got married there in the church. That story basically says it all. You don't have to have a doctorate in English literature to interpret it, I don't think. But let me just give you a simple interpretation for it. What does Mary do? What did she do in the painter's shop? Her presence purified the environment of the ugly stench of sin. I repeat, Mary's presence in the statue purified that foul, immoral atmosphere of the ugly stench of sin. One of the fruits of devotion to Mary, my friends, is that Mary pushes us away from sin and pushes us into her Immaculate Heart and the heart of Jesus. I repeat, Mary gently but firmly, she pushes us away from moral enemy number one, which is sin. Sin is arch enemy number one in our spiritual life. She pushes us away from that. And she gently draws us into her heart in the heart of Jesus Christ. And second, is that Mary, by her presence, you're going to be consecrating yourself to Mary. She will watch over you, and she will help you as well as your children not to fall off the cliff into a moral pitfall that could be jeopardize your eternal salvation. Those are two fruits of our consecration to Mary. Purifying our own inner world of that which is foul, that which is fetid, that which is putrid, that was putrefaction. These are strong words for sin. And sometimes we've got to use strong words to understand the real danger that we're involved in when we start to give into sin. And she will gently lead us into her Immaculate Heart and the Sacred Heart of Jesus. And in the future, as she saved this young woman, it's a true story, she saved this young woman from ruining her life and possibly ending up in hell. Mary can save us from so many moral pitfalls. None of us know how many years we're going to be living. None of us know the difficult circumstances that we're going to be exposed to. But we know that once you put this scapular on, my friends, you put the scapular on in about 5 minutes. What this means is that Mary is going to embrace you and place you in her Immaculate Heart. And that's the best place to be in the Immaculate Heart of Mary and the Sacred Heart of Jesus. So hopefully you'll remember that story. The story basically exemplifies really what consecration to Mary is, to keep us away from sin, to prevent it from falling off the cliff, but to find refuge in the two best places, finding refuge in the Immaculate Heart of Mary and the Sacred Heart of Jesus. Amen. So right now we're going to make our consecration to Mary. You will have your consecration form with you. If you don't, you can maybe raise your hands and some of our servants will be able to give you a consecration form. And I would invite all of you to, if you don't have a form, just raise your hand. You'll have it. Okay, there's one in the back. So together, act of consecration to Jesus through Mary, together, eternal incarnate wisdom, most loved and adored Lord Jesus, who died in your name, always in heaven, eternal God, and Mary, always virgin, and Mother of the Father, the heavenly splendor of your Father, all day, the very soul of the Lord. Petition. Yes. Also, for the privilege of bestowing you, Blessed Trinity. Write for blessing of any enrollment in the Brown Scapular. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, born of the Virgin Mary, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Right now we're going to bless the scapulars that we'll be imposing upon you. And the meaning of this is that by receiving the scapular, you're basically saying that you want to belong to Mary. You're in the school of Mary. You're in the heart of Mary. You're in the very essence of Mary. And you want to give everything you have, your past, your present, your future. All that you have no longer belongs to yourself, but you belong to Mary. So every day, you're going to be wearing your scapular. You'll be getting up in the morning. The first prayer will be consecrating yourself to Mary, kissing the scapular, and aware of by wearing the scapular that Mary has her arms embracing you, watch over you, protecting you, and you're basically going to be in the heart of Mary. That's really what it means. Prayer of blessing. Holy Father, you have wished that your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, should take our human flesh in the womb of the Virgin Mary, by the work and the Holy Spirit, grant to this, your sons and daughters of yours, who are about to wear devoutly the scapular of the family of the Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel, the grace of being clothed in Jesus the Lord, and all the circumstances of this life, and thus to attain eternal glory through Christ our Lord. Amen. Right now, you have your scapulars. I'm going to go down and I'll be blessing your scapulars. Just lift up your scapulars. I'll bless all of them as they go down. So in this moment, as in reception of Holy Communion, you'll come up in two lines and I'll be imposing the scapular. If you could have your scapular opened up, not tangled, and draw as close to me as possible, and I'll say, receive the scapular, as a sign of your devotion to Mary, and you say amen, and I'll impose it upon you. Receive this gift as a sign of your consecration to Mary.
Amen.
Receive this scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive this scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive this scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive this scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive this scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive this scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. If you could just draw closer, my arms are tired. Draw closer to me. Don't be afraid, okay? Okay, a little bit closer. Okay. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive the scapular as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of the consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of the consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of your consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup here as a sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as a sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as the sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as the sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as the sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as the sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as the sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as the sign of the consecration of Mary. Receive this cup as the sign of the consecration to Mary. Receive this cup as the sign of the consecration of Mary. The official enrollment in the scapular. So starting right now, if this is the first time you've ever done it, you actually belong to the Carmelite Order. And you'll receive all the special blessings that come from the Carmelite Order and their prayers as a result of this enrollment right now. And you belong to Our Lady Mount Carmel until you get to heaven. What a beautiful, beautiful gift this is. So the prayer of enrollment. Receive this scapular by which you enter the family of the brothers of the Blessed Virgin Mary of Mount Carmel. Wear it as a sign of the motherly protection of the Virgin and your pledge to imitate and serve her. May the Mother of God help you to be clothed in Christ. May He abide in you to the glory of the Trinity, and to dedicate yourself to the Church for the good of your brothers and sisters. Amen. By the faculties invested in me, I admit you to participate in all the spiritual benefits of the Order of Carmel. May the blessing of Almighty God, Father, Son, Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. Amen. Let's stand and show our great love to Mary right now with an applause. Okay, so we'll proceed for the second part of Mass, the liturgy of the Eucharist, and then after that we'll show our love for Mary by the Rosary and a beautiful Marian Eucharistic procession. So please be seated. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the mighty Father. Look, O Lord, upon the prayers and offerings of your faithful presented in commemoration of Blessed Mary, the Mother of God, that they may be pleasing to you and may confer on us your help and forgiveness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our always and ever to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name in veneration of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty. Dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Sanctus,
Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth. Pleni soci et tuam sana in excelsis benedicto in omnite nomine Domini hosanna in excelsis. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith we proclaim. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring it to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on this all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Let us offer to each other the sign of peace. Behold, O Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you enter my room. Say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Body Christ. Body Christ. Body Christ. Body Christ.
Amen.
Body Christ.
Amen.
Body Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
Bread of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Body of Christ.
Amen. Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Amen.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Thank you. Let us pray. May your church proclaim your greatness, O God. You have done great things for your faithful saint. Having been made partakers of eternal redemption, we pray, O Lord, that we who commemorate the mother of your Son may glory in the fullness of your grace and experience its continued increase for our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So right now, as part of our consecration, we'll expose the Eucharistic Lord, the Son of Mary, and we'll pray the Most Holy Rosary. We'll have our Eucharistic Marian procession and with the blessing with our Lord present in the Most Holy Sacrament of the altar.